I'm TV6 meteorologist Eric DeBroca, and here's your latest weather on demand forecast. Well, after a beautiful start to Saturday, it didn't end so nicely as more rain showers crossed through the area. And right now, we do have a stronger band of showers moving through Elger and then Delta County just east of Escanaba. That continues to march off to the east rather quickly, but notice off to the west as well, there are more scattered but very light showers. And those, once again, will be in the forecast. So pretty much, at least the first part here of July, we'll pick up where June left off. Well, it's been a rainy June, and going by these stats, you would believe it, actually, if you spend any time outside. It rained 25 of the 30 days, so 83% chance. If you were to step outside in June, you would have seen some rain come down at any given point. And more specifically, though, with the last 3 weeks, we've seen it rain 19 of the last 21 days, and that's 90% of the days showed some sort of rainfall. And this is pretty interesting here. The surplus for the entire month of June was actually 3.13 inches at the Weather Service. What's interesting about that is that's typically more rainfall that we normally see during the entire month of June. As far as highs today, we were in the 70s in Iron Mountain. That was our big winter there, 78. We were 68 in Escanaba, though. We did have a little bit of a lake component, a lake breeze, that is, in Munising, 63 there. Well, you can see from our area here that we are in the cooler air, as you see 61 from Sawyer, 63 from Thunder Bay, as the trough across the east continues to trek in the easterly direction, 76 from Chicago. But look off to the west, we haven't seen these numbers in about a month, or at least 3 to 4 weeks. 90 almost in Pier, 80s farther south than that, and it's that warm air. Finally, we haven't seen much of that really the last two and a half weeks in June, and that will be moving in our direction here. You can already see it. A lot of clear skies. Finally, nice summer days will be in our forecast for the 4th of July holiday. Notice, though, right where I'm standing, we can see that the low pressure system here will continue to spiral more rain showers through the course of the night Saturday into the first half of Sunday. Timing us out for you here on Future View, showers will continue as a cold front crosses the area early Sunday morning, late Saturday night. And so 10 a.m., basically the cold front will be through. But notice dry conditions finally will be with us, and high pressure will lock its grip over us. And that means departing rain showers moving off to the east. If you are traveling, though, downstate for the holiday weekend, that's where they're going to see some rain, particularly on Monday. Notice this front here actually stalls out, not too far, relatively speaking, to us, but we're going to be dominated by high pressure and beautiful days ahead. So what's left of the rainfall? Well, we can accumulate another quarter to about a half an inch basically across the central UP before some of that starts to fizzle out off to the east. And this is through Sunday morning. And then once we reach really later on in the afternoon, the skies will begin to clear out from the west. And that's why we have morning rain showers giving way to bouts of afternoon sunshine. Temperatures, though, coolest near Lake Superior shoreline, 65 that way. Munising will be the coolest there, right about 65. Marquette will do 67. Warmest, though, towards Iron Mountain, low 70s in the southern UP. Notice northwesterly winds, 8 to 18 miles per hour. We could see some gusts over 20 miles an hour throughout the day tomorrow. In your TV6 day forecast, we see a nice looking stretch where we are turning the corner here with this forecast, finally looking and feeling more like summer with a lot less rainfall in the forecast. We really don't see a rain return until Wednesday, and those are just really light showers and not going to be widespread really any of the days through the 6 day period. Temperatures do warm finally into the 80s by Thursday before cooling off by next Friday.